How we going, guys? The Loot Gamer over here, and welcome to another episode of Really Cool Gaming Loot. Over here, people, Final Fantasy XIV Shadowbringers Collector's Edition, and I am so excited to show you guys the details of this. Unfortunately, fellas, this Collector's Edition is only available on the Square Enix store, and it's sold out right now, but of course we can actually go onto the waiting list for this product to be relaunched. This will cost you $199 US over here. So in Australia, we'll pay approximately around $300 Australian. But let's go through all the features of this lovely collector's edition. Because as you guys know, I am the Loot Gamer and I love to unbox really cool things here. So please note the Windows physical collector's edition does not include an actual disc in the box. The game content is unlocked via a registration code. So in case you guys wanted to get the physical disc, unfortunately, we do not get it. But take part in the next saga of the critical acclaimed Final Fantasy XIV Online with the next legendary expansion pack, Shadowbringers. So honestly, fellas, I played Final Fantasy and I've really enjoyed it. And looking at the trailer, looks really damn awesome. Explore breathtaking new environments, encounter exotic new races, master exciting new jobs, and fight along prominent characters with the new trust system as you embark a new journey as a warrior of darkness. So, over 40 million players worldwide. So guys, so let's go through all of these juicy details in this collector's edition, yeah. So, the first thing we get over here, guys, is the Dark Knight figurine. And this is looking absolutely gorgeous. Look at those colors over there, guys. And I'm so curious to see what kind of materials they use. We get a high quality figure featuring the Warrior of Darkness as a Dark Knight, approximately 23 centimeters tall. So that's going to be looking like a really awesome piece there. We get ourselves the game, of course, which is with a really nice image there. A special art box, which is looking so damn cool. And I really love the artistry they put there. 80-page hardbook art book over here, which is looking really gorgeous here. We get ourselves sticker clings as well. And we get ourselves a playing card deck. So I really love what they're doing here. In-game content we get ourselves is a wind-up Fran minion, a grunt mount, and a revolver gunbreaker weapon. And this weapon is looking badass, fellas. So I'm absolutely loving this. But disclaimer, guys, content's subject to change. So this could actually change prior to launch. But let's just see what happens shortly here. But this is looking really awesome. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think of it. As we know, this is launching on July the 2nd, 2019, so pretty soon this is coming out. But let's go through all the sort of details again. So of course, we get ourselves an art box, an expertly crafted knight figurine, a Shadowbringers art book, a Shadowbringers logo sticker, and of course, the Final Fantasy XIV playing card deck. So this is a really awesome piece of loot here. But let's check out this important section here in case you guys want to see here. So please know that the Final Fantasy XIV Bringers expansion pack also includes Final Fantasy XIV Heaven Sword and Final Fantasy XIV Stormblood, which will be provided at release date. So you're getting a lot of goodies here for $200. You're getting yourselves two expansions plus the Shadowbringers expansion as well, which is pretty damn worth it. This product is not compatible with the Steam version of Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. If you've already purchased 14's Realm Reborn on Steam, then you must also purchase Final Fantasy's 14 Shadowbringers on Steam to upgrade your existing account. So make sure we pay attention to detail with this part of the effort in case you guys got the Realm Reborn. So products with a broken seal will not be returned, of course. Please note that you use the shipment service at your own risk. So signature confirmation is recommended. On or near release date delivery, while we try our best to schedule delivery, may arrive later, blah, 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 as you probably already know. Limited to one collector's edition per account. But let's go through the other details of this. So as you guys know, $200 US for this. If you guys don't want to grab that and only just grab maybe the standard copy, you're still able to grab that on GameStop.com, and that will cost you $40 US over here. So way more cheap and affordable than $200. But of course, you won't get the goodies that you get with the collector's edition. So of course, we get ourselves just the standard game over here. And what else do we get? We get ourselves the standard game and requires Final Fantasy Reborn to play. So you got to get the Reborn first before you get this, of course, because this is just an expansion from that. So as you know, guys, this is obviously for PC and also for PlayStation 4 and Steam. So as we know, this is all we really get here. So if you pre-order now, we will receive limited in-game items, as you guys saw. So we will get the Baby Gremlin Minion, as I told you guys earlier, and I can't even pronounce that, Erling. So an earring modeled after the Aetherius lights found in town after the land. Please do not attempt to teleport to yourself. These useful earrings feature attributes that will vary according to the user's class, job, and current level when equipped. Additionally, the earrings grant 30% increase in XP when worn, perfect for leveling your jobs to 70 in preparation for the Shadowbringers. So you get a sauce, really awesome earrings. Yeah, they give you the extra boost in XP. So you guys still get yourselves a really nice pre-order incentive there. So you know the game and itself, $40 over there. But in case you guys wanted to see how much we're paying in Australia, we are paying $54.95 for the PC copy and $70 for the PS4. So of course we get ourselves obviously the same sort of incentives as the other one in America over here. So we early access to the Shadowbringers, which you'll be able to get. Redeem your pre-order code during this specific period to receive early access. To be granted early access to play the new content, users need to be playing Final Fantasy, Stormblood, and have completed certain quests. So in order for you guys to get this in early access, you got to complete certain quests first. So, of course, we get ourselves the baby Gremlin Minion and the Aetherlight Earring as well, which you guys already know about. So, pretty good incentive, fellas. Let me know in the comments below whether you guys are thinking of picking this up. But of course, for PlayStation 4, the exact same incentives: early access, baby Gremlin Minion, and the Aetherlight Earring as well. So it's good to see we're getting that consistency across the board here. But honestly, fellas, this collector's edition is looking really beautiful, and I can't wait for this to pop. I would absolutely love to unbox this, but unfortunately, a bit pricey for us in Australia, paying about $350. On eBay, this is selling for more than 500 in Australia. Let me know in the comments below whether you guys were picking this up, because if I had the money, I would definitely pick this up. I am the Loot Game. If you guys enjoy, give me a thumbs up and a like, because I want to bring you guys some more awesome loot coming this month. Hopefully, something soon. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you later. Deuces.